All right, welcome back, everybody. I'm Geek. Today we've got the opportunity to talk to the designer of a brand new fantasy board game called Legends of Adventures. It's geared towards 9 through 14-year-olds, but adults can play too. It encourages teamwork and discussion as well. We welcome Zach Oberuth, the creator, to tell us all about Legends of Adventure. Check this thing out. This looks awesome. Zach, welcome to the program. And you designed this. You built this all by yourself, pretty much. I mean, you had some crowdfunding and, of course, a design team, but you came up with the concept.
Right. Actually, I've been making board games since I was a kid in Pennsylvania. Grew up in rural Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
Didn't have much money, but had cardboard and an imagination, and I made games ever since I was a kid. And as an adult, I had this idea for a cooperative game where people would work together. And I worked it all out on index cards, had it tested. We played for 6 months, got it the way I wanted it. And then the question is, okay, great. Now what do you
What do you do?
Yeah. And that's when we heard about Kickstarter.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the online crowdsourcing site. And we raised money through Kickstarter to actually hire an artist. And the artist we got was an actual old high school classmate, still lives in Pennsylvania.
Oh, nice. Okay.
And he played the game as a prototype, liked it, said, okay, I'm in, I'll do it. And he committed himself to creating over 100 original pieces of art, including the box, the board game design, everything.
Yeah.
And we love the art. That's an example of the art.
This thing is really cool, right?
Yeah, that's one of the monsters in the game.
So this is a trading card kind of based game? Is that how it works?
There's cards and dice. Yep, there's cards and dice. And so Mike Maddox, thank you, Mike, for all your work. It took him about 2 years to do all the art, believe it or not. And while he was doing that, I was learning about business because I'm a teacher, not a businessman. So my wife and I had decided that we didn't want to sell this idea to another company, that we wanted to run this as a small business. We put a lot of work into it. And so that's what we're doing. And in fact, after 3 years, when we finally got the first delivery, it was delivered to our house.
Mm-hmm.
And friends and my wife and I, we unloaded the boxes. We put it in every spare closet, every spare bedroom we had. And that's where it's stored. And then we had a distributor that wanted an order in Fort Wayne, Indiana. And, well, the most affordable way for me to do that was I borrowed a van from a friend, filled it to the gills with games, I grabbed my dog.
And you drove it on out there?
And I drove to Fort Wayne, Indiana, delivered the games myself, turned around and came back the same weekend.
Well, what are people saying about the game?
We've had a lot of good response. Charleston's been very encouraging. We've had a lot of local people. In fact, so many people supported us that we had a thank you event. We called it a red carpet release party at the local Cinnabar in Mount Pleasant.
Very cool.
It's kind of like a movie premiere.
Yeah.
And so we dressed up in a tux and everything. And we invited all of the people and businesses here in Charleston to come as a thank you. Thanks for helping us make this happen. Thanks for sticking with us for 3 years. And it was a really great event.
That tarot guy at Cinnabar is pretty nice, isn't he?
Yeah, it was very nice. Yeah.
Okay, so a lot of people say, oh, I could invent a board game. Oh, if I had a board game, I'd do it this way. You actually went out there and did it. Tell me about the challenges of actually developing a board game from scratch.
Sure. Well, you don't know what you don't know. You realize that the fun part was working all that out at Nick's Cards and figuring out how the game will play. It was fun to see the art come in. But then you had to realize, what about state taxes? What about online sales? What about manufacturing, shipping, customs, all these things that I had no clue about?
Right.
I had to learn, and I did that pretty quick over the course of those years while the art was being done.
So, Zach, a lot of people, you know, when they play these games, it's all kind of going against each other. Yours encourages teamwork, as you said. Tell me about why you wanted to make that kind of an essential characteristic of this game.
Sure. Well, playing a board game is really a social experience. And that experience can be positive and that experience can be negative. We've all played Monopoly where someone won and rubbed it in your face for the next, you know, month and a half.
Yeah.
So I wanted to create a game where there was going to be not just cooperation in how you play the game, but there was going to be dialogue. It's actually not turn-based, so it's not your turn, then my turn. It's let's talk about who has the best opportunity to help the team.
Nice.
So it makes a lot of dialogue and it forces a lot of discussion.
How long does it take a game? Because Monopoly, you just mentioned, using that example, takes a week and a half in my house at least. How about your game?
No, it usually takes between 60 and 90 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
The idea of the game is you're trying to complete 10 different adventures. You don't always do that. You're not always successful. So some games are shorter because you didn't quite make your goal.
There you go. And we can find it right now. I'm going to read this list off. You can get it at Wonderworks. You can get it at Barton's Toys, Hobbytown USA, Magnifilus Toy Emporium, your website, of course, which is
LegendsOfAdventureGame.com.
And Amazon. So make sure you go and check that out. Christmas is coming up. Sounds like a great gift. Zach, thank you so much for coming on here. And what an interesting concept, man. Congratulations with everything like that. And I hope it really works out for you.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
All right. Sounds great. Much more Low Country Live coming up.